And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
My name's Renn Stein. I go to All Saints Episcopal School, and I've lived in Tyler for 11 years. I have a variety of interests, from playing piano to playing tennis to managing my investment portfolio. But something I'm most proud of is thanks to a plastic tube, epoxy, and some LED lights. I've always loved technology and engineering, and I always wanted to know how things work. When I was 13, I took apart a broken iPhone to see all the components inside and made some educated guesses for what all those way too complicated components actually did. While my guesses were anything but truly educated, the experience was the most influential in developing my love of engineering. I later learned how to use a 3D printer, and that same year, All Saints expanded their fabrication resources to include a laser cutter, more than 10 3D printers, large workspaces, and every tool you could imagine. But I felt as though these tools weren't really being used to benefit the most people possible, and were really being restricted to only helping the 180 or so students in the high school. So I founded Makers on a Mission. It's a student-run organization focused on using engineering to help the community in any way possible. We use the fabrication tools that All Saints offers to create anything that can help those in need in East Texas. This was the first year of Makers on a Mission, and we had 22 members, which might not sound like a lot, but keep in mind my entire grade is only 41 people. So I knew that community engagement was important, and I knew I wanted to help out Tyler, but how could 3D printing fabrication really do that? I was inspired by a field trip to the Treatment and Learning Center last year. For those of you who haven't heard of the Treatment Learning Center or visited, it's a treatment center for children living with autism of any age in East Texas. While I was there, I watched through a one-way mirror as a teacher worked one-on-one with a student who was maybe 5 years old. I was amazed by the insane patience and attention the teacher gave as she slowly and deliberately taught and retaught the same steps to the student. It wasn't so much about the actual task the teacher was teaching, but more about the student being able to keep focused even when surrounded by all sorts of distractions in a playroom. So I knew I wanted to help the Treatment and Learning Center, and after meeting with some people at the TLC, we decided the perfect way to do that would be to create bubble tubes. A bubble tube is basically just a foot-tall plastic tube with water filled inside with lights and a bubbler in. It sounds relatively simple, but the end result is something like a lava lamp, but only more soothing and more mesmerizing. And they really are mesmerizing. I can promise you that we've all spent way more time than we'd like to admit staring at them rather than actually working on them in the process. So we thought the process would be relatively easy, and we started at the beginning of the school year. Unfortunately, we quickly realized it really wasn't that easy. So we wanted to do them for as cheap as possible to make as many as possible. So we bought some cheap plastic tubes we found online that we assumed would hold water. They did not. That was our first of many issues. We solved it by using a silicone-based sealant to draw a line around the bottom where it was leaking, and after a couple tries, they were watertight. So we were then ready to drill a hole for the lights and bubbler, and this is where we ran into our biggest problem. Thanks to some expert Amazon searching, I'd found a circular device that had LEDs in the middle with a ring of stone on the outside. This allowed us to combine the two parts, the lights, which created obviously the light to make the water different colors, and the stone, which distributed air from an outside bubbler into the small mesmerizing bubbles that make a bubble tube. Unfortunately, when we put these in the bottom and put the cables out the hole near the bottom of the tube, that's when the problem occurred. No matter what we did, every time we put sealant in the hole to try to make the tube watertight, it would not stick to the rubber tube that brought air from the bubbler to the stone. We tried over and over, and every time it leaked the same. Finally, our teacher sponsor for Makers on a Mission, Miss Adair, came with the idea to use epoxy on the rubber tube first to give the sealant something different to bond to. Finally, it worked, and we were able to move on to making a base for the tube to sit on that would hold the bubbler and the wires. We made this box out of just pieces of wood, drilled holes for the wiring and for the bubbler, and then painted the whole thing black to look a bit nicer. Finally, we were on to the last step, creating something to hold the tube on top of the box to have a finished bubbler. We did this by 3D printing it because we thought this was the place where we could use the fabrication resources in the 3D printers at All Saints. After 4 or 5 tries, we finally had a successful one that held the tube perfectly and the wires perfectly. Finally, we had a completed tube. After countless wasted tubes of sealant, more than 20 soaked countertops, and an incredible amount of nasty splinters, we had a finished product and we were ready to deliver it. We decided our first delivery should go to Odin, a teen living with severe autism from Miss Adair's church. We decided to deliver it to him on a Thursday night while he was at Grand Slam because his family was there bowling. When we first walked into Grand Slam, I saw Odin from across the room, and he was looking around frantically and was very clearly distraught and making a lot of noise. He was very clearly overwhelmed by the crowd. But the second we plugged in the tube, immediately you could see his muscles relax as all his focus went on the tube and he forgot about the chaos around him. We handed him a button to control the tube, and he just continuously pressed it on and off, just sitting, smiling, and staring quietly at the tube. He eventually accidentally dropped the button and immediately started making noise and was clearly focusing back in on the chaos around him. But as soon as I handed the button back to him, he calmed down and everything was okay again. His parents have told us that since delivering it, it now sits in his room where he falls asleep looking at the bubble tube every night, and that it's still working perfectly today. Seeing Odin so impacted by my work made the entire process and the mini splinters instantly worthwhile. I knew that I could actually make a difference in someone's life, and I wanted to broaden that impact. Now, I know what you're thinking. Can a bubble tube really cure Odin's autism? No. But our hope is that it can at least make his life just a little bit easier. Some things can't be solved, but at least we can help a teen sleep through the night. We can take small steps to make someone's life brighter, even if that comes in the form of a foot-tall tube full of water. My work may create small victories, but they still matter. And since then, I've done more than just bubble tubes. After the coronavirus pandemic made its way to East Texas, I used a 3D printer to print mask adjusters. They're basically just little pieces of plastic that go on the back of your head for the mask straps to attach to. It allows the mask to fit better, and it also takes the pressure off of your ears if you're wearing it for long durations. I ended up delivering 58 of these mask adjusters to healthcare workers around East Texas. I recently graduated from high school, and I'm attending Stanford University to study mechanical engineering in the fall. Before I leave, I will do everything I can to ensure that Makers on a Mission becomes a long-lasting club at All Saints' campus, because I want the incredible resources of the school to continue to be used to help those in need around East Texas. These are strange times we're living in, with lots of uncertainty for all of us. But who knows when a tiny bit of 3D printed plastic can make the world just slightly better of a place.
Renn, great story, sir. Great story. So what do you hope people take from your presentation tonight?
I mean, the biggest thing is just that you don't have to like cure cancer or do something incredible to make a difference. Even if it is something as small as taking someone else's design and printing tiny pieces of plastic to help with masks or something like that, or even the smallest thing of just a little bit of kindness towards like healthcare workers. I mean, anything you do can help. Just because it's not something grand doesn't mean you shouldn't do it.
Awesome. One thing we know for sure is that your future is well beyond the bubble. There it is right there. All right, Renn, thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Mr. Renn Stein. Thank you for finding ways to keep us in the loop.
Thank you.